been a while since I've done this. I'm here to continue this empire that I've created from the ground up. It's time to give this aquatic odyssey the credit that it deserves. Now, I know I might be a little bit behind talking about this show, but I really don't care because I'm here now. I'm here to enter the discussion. H2O is a look into the life of three teenage girls who stumble onto some magical mermaid abilities, as one does.
What do we do?
Try to live.
We follow Cleo, Ricky, and Emma. This show means so much to me because it's probably one of the first shows I've ever really binged. Netflix streaming was still really new, but I mean, along with the array of masterpieces they had, little Daniel just stumbled upon it and decided, I'll give this a watch. Little did I know, this saga was chock full of masterful content and sequences that I just needed to inhale.
Really, it's fine. I am so sorry. Cleo!
And I'll be honest, this show could have gotten boring really fast, like really fast. Like, episode 3, not looking good.
What about the turtles?
I'm really disappointed in you, Dad.
Cleo?
But the writers really learned how to spice up the show. Once they got in their groove, they created this lore. I think we can all agree that the Full Moon episodes are some of the best television that's ever existed. Ever? Now, for those ignorant, sad, lonely viewers probably, the Full Moon episodes are basically like where the full moon puts the mermaids into like a trance or gives them like extra abilities. So it gave the show an opportunity to really spice things up and like make some of the main characters villains for an episode or give them extra abilities for an episode or something like that. I mean, like the siren episode, was amazing.
We had a good thing, a very, very good thing.
Granted, I haven't seen it in like 7 years. No, definitely longer than 7 years. So for this video in particular, I just wanted to break down one of the most climactic Full Moon episodes there are in existence. Now that's season 2, episode 26. What's it called? Unfathomable. Why can't I say this word? Oh my God.
What was that?
'Cause I'm no ordinary. So we start off the episode and Lewis and Cleo, the will they won't they couple of the series, are together. But one problem, Lewis's ex-girlfriend is super jealous and she's a recent mermaid.
This is the most impressive mess I personally have ever seen.
Not only is Charlotte like super powerful, but she's also out for blood kind of. So that just like was not very good. Alexa, stop. So the girls just like run into Charlotte in the old cafe, the hangout cafe.
I'm more mermaid than all three of you put together.
Why is every scene in this show Oscar worthy? Like I can't even take it. And they end up just like warning her about the full moon, and then Charlotte's just like super upset for some reason still. So she like makes them float, and then Charlotte's like bad, okay? She like raises them 4 feet in the air and then drops them. So she's like mermaid Thanos. So we come to find out in this like super dramatic conversation between Lewis and this old guy that like the planets are aligning and that's like a really big deal.
Forever. Wow.
So basically like the planetary alignment can reverse the mermaid powers if like the mermaids are in the moon pool at the right time. I can't believe that was just a sentence I said on the internet. Okay.
I knew you'd come looking for me. I've missed you.
Toxic. So Charlotte like doesn't listen to the warning. She's like, she's all in, okay? You have to respect she is all in, she's committed. And she soaks up the moon beams and she like gets some crazy power. So she like starts attacking the house that the girls are in. The house goes berserk, there's water everywhere. The girls are trying to avoid the water because obviously if they touch the water, they'll turn to mermaids. Lewis, the genius that he is, convinces Charlotte to go to the moon pool on Mako Island. And he's just like, yeah, you know, you want to go to the moon pool, right? You feel it in your bones. So go to the moon pool. She's like, meet me there, I guess.
Fish.
Meanwhile, like Emma's boyfriend, Ash, is super mad because all this weird stuff's going on and no one's telling him anything, which is just like, what else could it be? You know, Like, they're mermaids. It's kind of obvious. If you didn't put that together by now, then maybe you don't deserve to know. So Cleo, like the sympathetic main character she is, follows Lewis to the moon pool. And she's like, Lewis, like, she's gonna get you or whatever. So, and then Lewis is like, no, you can't be in the moon pool because like, you're gonna, you know, transform. And then after he tells them this, Charlotte's like, it was all a part of my plan.
You used me as bait.
Smart. Unlike your little friend here.
But Cleo could just like walk out, which I don't really understand why she doesn't, but she chills in there. And then her besties show up. It's gonna be fine. The besties are here.
What's happening? Where is she?
I didn't realize this was the Avengers. And the rest of the episode really is just like a battle of wits and strategy. So like the girls with each of their powers create like a super powerful mermaid storm, and it like sweeps Charlotte up into the air and then plops her right into the moon pool right as the moon is going over Mako Island.
Nice legs.
Boom. Roasted.
Her mermaid dreams were ruined forever, but at least she learned a good lesson.
I guess I wasn't really cut out for being a mermaid.
That was it. That was the lesson. I didn't say it was a very deep lesson.
All I ever wanted was for you to care for me.
Not fair. It's a company. It's in a company that should be cut.
Emma has her moment with her boyfriend where she tells him, and I don't think you understand the significance of these final sequences, because this is the last time that we have the original trio together. This is the last time we see them ever, because Claire Holt went ahead and left the show in season 3 to work on another great opportunity that she had. It was called Messenger 2, The Scarecrow. Has anyone heard of this? Because I have not. And it sounds like it did a lot for her career. So happy she skipped out on season 3. So after this, nothing is the same, and the H2O legacy crumbles from there. So they only go for one more season, and then they call it a wrap until Netflix reboots the show. And we're not even gonna talk about that. We're not even gonna talk about Mako Mermaids with Lucy Fry. And you guys know I have standards. It's just so sad. Like, I don't even need to say anymore. I can just like play the intro. Like, where's the heart? Where's the soul? Where's the passion? Where's the fun? Where's the music? What is this song? That's all I had. Didn't really have like a thesis or kind of like an approach to this. I was just like chit-chatting, so. 'Cause